Hi friends, good evening. Welcome to EduTap. So please do let me know if you're able to see me properly, if my voice is audible to you guys. Good evening. I really hope that your preparations are going well. And here we are back with the marathon series where we are covering important MCQs for RBI Grade B 2019 phase 1, right? So yesterday we had discussed the questions from August and July, and today first what we will do is we'll complete July 2019, and then we will take up the next month, that is the previous month, June 2019 as well. So good evening all of you. I can see that people are joining in. We'll just wait 1 or 2 minutes for your friends to join in and then we shall quickly begin with it, right? So I can see, yes, good evening to everyone. Arijit, Bijit, Rakesh, Sandeep, so all of you are there, and thank you so much for joining in for the third lecture straight in a row, right? So let's just wait for 1 or 2 minutes as I told you, and then we'll quickly go with the session, right? So guys, till now we have completed September 2019, we are going to complete July, okay, we have completed August, and today we'll be done with June as well. So I want all of your participation today so that we can immediately start and finish June and July today itself, so that in the tomorrow session we can take up October and May, right? So that is the plan that we have right now, okay? And as I told you guys, you should have read something previously, okay, and this will act as a revision series wherein we'll be asking you questions, and for 2 seconds we'll give you time, and then you need to immediately think about the answer, right? So let me just see if people are joining in, just 1 or 2 minutes, and by 7:04 or 7:03 we will quickly start the session, okay? And I really hope, friends, that these sessions are, you know, helping you guys, okay? So yes, Desh, Deepak, good afternoon, good evening in fact, right? And yes, October will be taken tomorrow, okay? And we will split it maybe tomorrow and day after. Till 5th of November, we have these sessions being run, right? Yes, we are not in a hurry. We will quickly do that, okay? And I'll not be reading the options as we have got the feedback from our students, right? So yes, no options. We'll not be reading options at all. We'll just read the question and then you need to tell us the answer. Maybe 1 or 2 seconds break we will allow so that you can immediately think and come up with the answers, okay? So I can see that many people are joining in. Thank you so much for being there straight in for the third day of the session as well. And yes, guys, so yes, I think just a minute more, okay? And then we'll quickly begin, okay? Yes, I'm not going to read the options, do not worry. And friends, keep revising this again. We also would provide the PDF of this particular lecture at the end of the session. You can go to EduTap's Telegram channel and you can download the PDF, right? Fine. So guys, let's start, I think. And okay, so we can see people are saying let's start at 500. Okay, so just a minute more and then we'll move forward. Let your friends join in at the later part of the session. Okay, and we'll also be coming up with, you know, one strategy session for the last 7 days. That also will be coming up with tomorrow, so do not worry, okay? Last 7 days strategy, that also will be there, okay? Yes, people are joining in and we are good to go. Okay, I can see that Rishabh is saying that read the options in your mind so that we get that amount of time. Do not worry, after each question we'll give you 1 or 2 seconds so that you can think about the answer and come up with it, right? Okay, fine, let's move on. So the first question for today, guys, so we'll be finishing the month of July 2019 as I told you, and then we'll take up June 2019, right? Okay, so the first question for today: who among the following is the present chief economic advisor of India who prepared economic survey 2018-19? So guys, start and give me the answer. We'll just give you 1 or 2 seconds to think about this question and then we'll quickly move ahead, right? So you need to tell me the answer, okay? So we can see that people have started answering. Great. Okay. So fine. I see most of them are coming out with the answer 1, 2, 1, 2. Let's see what is the correct answer for this question. So friends, the answer is Krishnamurthy Subramaniam. Okay. So he is the one who is the present chief economic advisor and he prepared the economic survey 2018-19. Right. Okay. So next, As per the Economic Survey 2019, what should be the real GDP growth rate of India in order to achieve the target of $5 trillion economy by 2024-25? Okay, just take one or two seconds and tell me the answer for this particular question. Okay, so I can see people are coming out with the answers, and let's see which is the correct one. You need to know that real GDP growth rate of India, and this is a target that India has set to achieve $5 trillion economy by 24-25. Okay, so the answer for this particular question, friends, it is 8%. Okay, so real GDP growth rate of 8% has to be achieved if we want to be a $5 trillion economy by 2024-25, right? Okay, so I can see so many answers pouring in quickly. Okay, so let me know in between if I'm really fast or if I'm slow. So according to your feedback, we can alter the pace of the session as well. That's not a problem. Okay, so the next question, friends, which of the following has become the first and the only Indian manufacturing plant to be included in the World Economic Forum's Global Lighthouse Network? Okay, so it is a conglomeration where all the manufacturers are coming together. So you need to tell me the answer for this particular question. You can see the options on your board. Okay, so you need to tell me which is the first and the only Indian manufacturing plant. Okay, so this is something which was in news. Okay, so as I told you, your feedback is always welcome throughout the session. Okay, so think about this answer, and the answer for this is Tata Steel Kalinganagar. Okay, so this is the correct answer for it. Let's move to the next question. So in which of the following cities was the World Skills India International Cloud Computing Challenge 2019 held? Okay, so see the venue. You can see the options on your screen. Okay, so I can see people coming out with the answers. So whenever for phase one, if you see, venue is very important whenever there are important conventions or summits or any other meetings being held. Okay, so I can see people coming out with the answer as four, I think. Yes, it will be good if you can even type your options. Okay, so that I don't get confused for what which question are you answering. Okay, so the answer for this particular question, friends, it is New Delhi. Okay, so let us move to the next question. Which of the following became the first country in the world to pass the legislation which is dubbed GAFA? Okay, it's Google, Apple, Facebook, Amazon tax on digital giants. Okay, so quickly with the answers, friends, and I would appreciate if you write the answer in the chat box. Okay, rather than 1, 2, 3, 4, it is going to help us out. Okay, so you need to tell me the answer for this particular question. Okay, and then I can move forward. So for this, the answer is France. Okay, so France has become the first country, and this is GAFA tax. GAFA also can be a term which can be asked in the examination, so make sure you know this as well. Okay, so moving to the next question, friends, which of the following company has launched India's first ethanol based motorcycle? Okay, so as we know, we are moving towards a greener India to avoid pollution. This is a very major step. Okay, and you need to tell me which particular company is it. Okay, so okay, I'll try not to say, okay, that's a habit that I have, so I'll just avoid that. Okay, yes, again, it is the answer for this particular question is Chennai based TVS Motor Company. Okay, so this is the particular company which has launched India's first ethanol based motorcycle. Moving to the next question, which of the following NBFC has become the first to receive loan worth $100 million from the Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank? Okay, so you need to tell me, see the options and tell the answer. So basically, if you see that one other question, a static question can be asked. So the headquarters of AIIB, what is it? You can mention that also in the comment section below. The answer for this particular question, it is L&T Infrastructure Finance Company Limited, LTIF. And you can also mention where is the headquarters of AIIB. Usually it is confused with the other banks. Okay, like you have ADB, you have NDB, all these headquarters, usually you get confused. So try mentioning that in the comment section as well. Moving to the next question. In which of the following cities has PayPal Holdings Inc. opened its third global technology center in India? There are already two centers in India. One is Bengaluru, other is Chennai. Let me just tell you that. Now you need to guess which is the third, where is the third center opened? So you need to see the options on your screen and let me know the answer for it. The answer for this particular question, friends, it is Hyderabad. Okay, so Hyderabad has become the third city after Chennai and Bengaluru, okay, where PayPal has opened its global technology center. Moving to the next question, which of the following entity has partnered with Niti Aayog to support the growth of a robust ecosystem to promote women entrepreneurs in India under the aegis of Women Entrepreneurship Platform? So this is, the options are very confusing. You might, see that the close options would be, according to me, WhatsApp and Microsoft India. So let's see if you can guess this particular answer. And please keep giving me the feedback if I'm going too fast or too slow so that I can adjust the pace according to your convenience. That also can be done very appropriately, right? So the answer for this particular question, friends, it is WhatsApp, okay? So Niti Aayog has partnered with WhatsApp for this particular initiative. Moving to the next question, Dash edition of economic census by the Ministry of Stats and Program Implementation is to be held in 2019 after a gap of 5 years in India. So which edition is this of economic census? You can see the options and I'll just give you 1 or 2 seconds so that you can quickly come out with the answer. So I can say most of you are pouring in with the answers in the chat section below, and that's appreciable. Okay, so okay, I can move fast then. I can see most of you are saying speed is fine, too fast, too slow. Let me see. Let me just increase a little bit. The answer for this particular question, friends, it is the 7th edition of economic census. Okay. Moving to the next question, in which of the following cities has Infosys recently opened its new state-of-the-art cyber defense center? So just see the options quickly and you can tell me the answer for it. So we are talking about the city where Infosys has opened its new state-of-art cyber defense center. The answer for this particular question, it is Bucharest, okay, in Romania. So you can see the capital also. This can be useful as well. Next, 113, which of the following organization has been selected for the President's Award for Excellent CSR Corporate Social Responsibility Program for introducing and implementing star rating scheme? So you can see the options on your screen. Now immediately come out with the answer. I can see people are coming up and that's very appreciable. So let me just try going a little faster. If you can tell me, I'll also slow the speed later. So the answer is National Aluminium Company Limited, NALCO. It has been selected for the very prestigious President's Award for Excellence CSR. Okay. Next question, which of the following journalist was awarded with the Lifetime Achievement Award in recognition of his contributions to the UK-India relationship in 2019 UK-India Awards? So you can see the options on your screen. So quickly come out with this answer. And I can see that many of you are coming up with the previous question answer that was regarding NALCO. I can also see that feedback. That is also good. For this one, the particular answer is Sir Mark Tully. Okay, so he was the one who was awarded with the Lifetime Achievement Award. Moving on to the next question, Dash is the first civil servant and IPS officer who conquered the 7 summits challenge. So you need to tell me what is it. 1 or 2 seconds would be fine. And the answer for this particular question, friends, it is Aparna Kumar. So Aparna Kumar has become the first civil servant and IPS officer who conquered the 7 summits challenge. So I really hope that all of you are coming up with this pace and we are at it, right? So most of you are giving the correct answers also. Moving on to the next question, Pankaj Advani, a very well-known personality in sports who was honored with Sports Person of the Year 2019 award, is associated with which of the following sport? Okay, so he plays 2 sports, so I can clearly tell you the answer for this is billiards and snooker. Pankaj Advani is a very well-known face in billiards and snooker. So this was a little bit of an easy question where you can spot the answer. You can see him here in the picture. Okay. Moving on to the next question, which of the following entity was awarded with World Economic Forum's Technology Pioneers Award 2019, right? So many awards are there and we are trying to cover most of them because there's a probability that you might get 1 or 2 in the examination. The answer for this particular question, friends, it is Quantela Inc. Fine. So we can see that most of you are coming out with the answers and that's brilliant. And thank you for joining in, guys. And moving to the next question, who among the following have been awarded the 2019 Global Excellence Award of the US-India Strategic Partnership Forum? So very well-known personalities. You can see the name as well. We'll just quickly come out with the answer. And the correct answer for this particular question, friends, it is Azim Premji, Wipro Chairman, and Ajaypal Singh Banga. So he is the CEO of Mastercard Company, right? So these two personalities have been awarded 2019 Global Excellence Award of the US-India Strategic Partnership Forum. Great. So the next question, which of the following Indian city has been inscribed into the UNESCO's list of the World Heritage Sites recently? That is in the month of July 2019. A very beautiful city, right? It's also called as, there's a name given to that city as well. So let's see if you guys can guess this particular answer. So the answer for this particular question being, it is Jaipur, the pink city. So recently in July 2019, its name has been inscribed into the UNESCO's list of the World Heritage Sites, right? So I can see people coming up with their answers, and that's great. Moving to the next question, which among the following Indian para-athlete has won 3 silver medals in the 4th World Yoga Festival and Championship 2019? So you can see the various personalities being listed. So the para athlete is Toran Yadav. Okay, he's quite young. Toran Yadav has received this particular award in the World Yoga Festival and Championship 2019. So yes, most of you are attempting it and keep doing so till the end, friends. Moving to the next particular question, in which of the following cities was the 43rd session of the United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization World Heritage Committee held? Okay, so we are talking about the 43rd session of UNESCO World Heritage Committee. So you need to tell me the name where it was held, the venue basically. So the answer for this particular question, it is Baku, Azerbaijan. Okay, so again, the capital also, you can just immediately memorize it here. Moving on to the next question, who among the following was named as the Men's Footballer of the Year 2019 at the All India Football Federation's Award? So you can see very famous options there. There can be close options. And the answer for this particular question, it is Sunil Chhetri. Okay. And if you guys have any information, tell me who has won it in the women's category. Okay, so let me see if you know it. Just mention that in the comment section below if you're aware who has taken the award in the women's category. Okay, so let me see if you answer it. And the next question out here is, which of the following Indian films was honored with the Network for the Promotion of Asian Cinema Award for Best Asian Film at the 23rd edition of BIFAN in South Korea? So you can see that very prominent movies. There can be a confusion between Uri and Gully Boy. They were very famous at that point of time. So regarding Moti Bagh, yesterday we had dealt, the day before yesterday, we had dealt a question regarding it. It's a very important documentary based on the life of a farmer. Okay. So the answer for this particular question is Gully Boy. Okay, so let me just pause here, and I can see that most of you are giving the correct answer. Asha Lata Devi, the personality who has won the award in the women's football category, okay, for Women Footballer of the Year award. So great, I can see most of you are keeping in touch with the current affair. So a quick revision out here. Moving to the next question, which of the following railway zone has won the Best Innovation Award of Indian Railways 2018-19 for its strategy Plan B? Okay, so you need to tell me the answer for this. Which railway zone is it? You can take 1 or 2 seconds. So the answer for this particular question is Northeast Frontier Railway. So this particular railway zone has won the Best Innovation Award. It has come out with a strategy of Plan B. Okay. Fine. So next question, in which of the following places was the 9th edition of the SARC Film Festival 2019 held? So we are talking about SARC Film Festival. And the answer for this particular question, friends, it is Colombo, Sri Lanka. So it was held here. We'll also see one question related to the important awards being won in the SARC Film Festival. So yes, the next question is regarding that. So which of the following films has won 4 awards, including Best Feature Film at 9th edition of the SARC Film Festival held in Colombo? We have just now seen a question regarding its venue. Okay, so the answer for this particular question, a very popular film, very highly acclaimed one, Nagar Kirtan. It is, the director is Kaushik Ganguly. So keep this particular information in mind. This is important. Moving to the 127th question, who among the following was conferred with the Gandhi Mandela Peace Medal 2019 during the first edition of this particular initiative? So this is the first edition. Again, it makes the question all the more important. So the answer for this particular question, there can be a confusion. Most of you might be tempted to go with Dalai Lama. But the correct answer for this particular question is Thich Nhat Hanh. I don't know if I have pronounced it right. So he is a global spiritual leader. So he has been conferred with the first initiative here. So please make sure you know this particular answer. So the picture of Thich Nhat Hanh is here. Next question, which of the following campaign has received the Pacific Asia Travel Association Gold Award 2019 under the Marketing Primary Government Destination category? So you can see the campaign's name, and let me tell you, it's a very familiar name which you hear a lot of time in the ads as well, advertisements. So this can help you to come out with the answer, right? So the answer for this particular question, friends, it is Find the Incredible You, Incredible India. This is a campaign which has received this particular award. Moving on to the next question, who among the following has overtaken Bill Gates to become the second richest person in the world as per Bloomberg Billionaires Index 2019? So the second richest person has actually displaced one of the prominent personalities before, Bill Gates. So let's see who is it. We tend to see the most familiar names, but it is a little unfamiliar here. The answer for this is Bernard Arnault. Okay, so he has overtaken Bill Gates to become the second richest person in the world. So here is his picture. You can just relate it with this. Next question, which of the following NBFC microfinance institutions was awarded for outstanding performance in terms of SHG self-help group linkage in Tamil Nadu for 2018 from NABARD? So an award being received. So 1 or 2 seconds would be enough for you to answer this particular question, guys. Buck up. I can see most of you coming out and giving your answers. I want all of you to come there, write your answers in the chat section below, right? So the answer for this particular question is Repco Microfinance. Next question, who among the following bagged the Mr. South Asia award at the 12th South Asia Bodybuilding and Physique Sports Championship 2019 held in Kathmandu, Nepal? So you can see prominent names here, and the answer for this particular question is Ravinder Kumar Malik. So he has bagged the Mr. South Asia award. So guys, moving on, you can see the picture of Mr. Ravinder Kumar Malik here on your screens. Okay, next question, which of the following company topped the Fortune Global 500 list 2019? Okay, so we are talking about the Fortune Global list. So you need to tell me the country's name. We'll also see among the Indian companies who has topped it. So just a second would be enough for you guys to give me the answer. And it is Walmart. Okay, so Walmart has topped the Fortune Global 500 list. Talking about India, it is Reliance Industries Limited has topped among the Indian companies, and it is placed at rank number 106, right? So basically, Reliance Industries Limited has displaced Indian Oil Corporation to be among the top firm in India. Moving on to the next question. Who among the following was conferred with the prestigious Indian Woman of Influence Award at the House of London's House of Lords in London? So you can see the options on your screen. So is it the answer for this particular question? It is Priya Priyadarshini Jain. Okay, so she has been awarded Indian Woman of Influence Award at the House of Lords in London. Moving to the next question, guys. So it is here, her picture. Who among the following became the first Indian to be crowned with Miss Deaf World 2019 held in South Africa? So again, an important feat where Indian girl has been crowned Miss Deaf World 2019. So you can just take 1 or 2 seconds. And the answer for this particular question, it is Vidisha Balian. I guess she belongs to UP, Vidisha Balian. So she has taken this feat out here. And next question, who among the following was awarded with the People's Choice Prize at the Boston International Sand Art Championship 2019? This question is pretty simple because this particular artist is very famous, sand artist. And the answer for this particular question, it is Sudarshan Patnaik, okay, a very well-known personality in sand art. So this is a pretty easy one for you guys. Coming to the next question, you can see one of his artwork here, and this is a person. Which of the following states Rasagulla has received the geographical indications tag after West Bengal? So let me tell you that West Bengal was the first state to receive GI tag when it comes to Rasagulla. But again, a second state also has been conferred upon with the GI tag. So there was a tussle also going on for a certain point of time. The answer for this particular question, it is Odisha. Okay, so very easy. West Bengal already has received. The second state who has received after West Bengal is Odisha, right? Okay, moving on to the next question. DD News recently received Champions of Empathy Award from Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla for what? So what is the reason for which DD News recently received this particular award? The answer for this particular question, friends, it is spreading awareness about hepatitis. So this is very important. Just mark this particular question. I can see all of you are coming out and giving your answers. It's really appreciable. And this is a third day in a row. So guys, do give me the feedback if you want me to slow the pace or increase the pace. That also can be done based on your feedback. Moving on to the next question, who among the following became the first pilot of the Indian Air Force to perform 8,500 feet wingsuit skydive jump from the Mi-17 V-5 helicopter? So again, you can see these names on your screen. This is a feat that has been achieved for the first time. It is Tarun Chaudhary. Okay, so please memorize this particular name. Moving to, yeah, this is his particular, this picture. Next question, who among the following was appointed as the MD, Managing Director and CEO of the Indian Overseas Bank? Recent appointments are also being asked in the examination. And the answer for this particular question is Karnam Sekhar. Moving to the next question, who among the following has been selected to lead the ECB, European Central Bank? So this is a very prominent name. The answer for this particular question, friends, it is Christine Lagarde. So she has been selected to lead ECB, European Central Bank. Moving to the next question, it is who among the following has been nominated by the European leaders to lead the European Commission? Okay, so again, an important appointment being done. And the answer for this particular question, it is Ursula von der Leyen. She is the Germany's defense minister. So she has been nominated by the European leaders to lead the European Commission. Okay. Next one is the Kriakos Mitsotakis was recently sworn in as the new PM of which country? So the answer for this particular question, it is Greece, European country. Moving on to the next question, which of the following former Indian cricketer was appointed as the head of cricket at National Cricket Academy by BCCI recently? Very familiar names in the Indian cricket. And the answer for this particular question out here, it is Rahul Dravid. So the Wall of India, popularly known as Sir. And yes, other options are equally confusing. So that's the reason here. Next question, who among the following was appointed as the Managing Director, MD and Chief Financial Officer of the World Bank Group recently? So this is again an important question related to appointment. Answer is Anshula Kant. So yes, moving on to the next question, friends. Who among the following was appointed as the international judge of the Singapore International Commercial Court recently? Okay, the answer for this particular question is Justice A.K. Sikri. Moving on to the 146th question, which of the following country has appointed former Indian cricketer and wicketkeeper Kiran Shankar More as interim coach of its cricket team? You need to tell me the name of the country. So I can see most of you are giving the answers on track. So the correct one for this particular question, it is United States of America. Moving on, who among the following was recently appointed as the new governor of Uttar Pradesh? So she has been appointed after she has been shifted from earlier state, and the answer is Anandi Ben Patel, and she's the first woman governor of UP. So this also can be noted. Moving on to the next question, who among the following was recently appointed as a private secretary to Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi? So guys, the answer for this particular question, it is Vivek Kumar. Coming on to the next question, so Dash became the first Indian origin Home Secretary of United Kingdom's UK, that is United Kingdom. The answer for this particular question, it is Preeti Patel. So she has become the first Indian origin Home Secretary of UK. Next question, who among the following was recently appointed as the new chairman of the Public Accounts Committee? important one, and the answer is Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary. So he has been appointed as the new chairman of Public Accounts Committee. Next question, who among the following was recently appointed as the next Director General of the BSF Border Security Force? So I can see most of you are coming out with the answers, and the correct one for this particular question being VK Jory, recently being appointed as the next DG of BSF. Next question, Baba Kavaj was recently launched in India. So it is related to what? So what is it? Okay. You can think for 2 seconds for this particular question. And it is bulletproof jacket. So Baba Kavaj is related to, it is a bulletproof jacket, name of it. So here it is, you can see on your screen. It is developed by Bark. Next, Care for You is an app which is launched by IIT Kharagpur for what? Okay, for it addresses which section of the society? And the answer for this particular question, it is elderly section. Okay, so the elderly people, Care for You, it's an app launched by IIT Kharagpur. Veer Chotrani is associated with which of the following sport? Okay, and the answer for this particular question, friends, you can think for a second or two, it is squash. And do not worry, we shall be providing the PDF of this particular lecture once this lecture is done. So you can refer the PDF quickly as well. Okay, the next question, who among the following has won gold medal in women's 200 meter in Poznan Athletics Grand Prix in 2019 held in Poland? So all the Grand Prix are important. So usually they ask these kind of questions. You'll at least get one question of this nature in examination. The answer is Hima Das. Okay. Next question, Vijender Singh Beniwal is associated with which of the following sport? So very famous personality, we have seen him in couple of tournaments, and the answer is boxing. So the next question, who among the following won the men's singles title in 2019 Wimbledon Championship? Very prominent personality, it is Novak. So he was the one who won men's singles title in 2019 Wimbledon Championship. Next question, who among the following was the first Romanian player to win women's singles title in 2019 Wimbledon Championship? So we can see the player is from Romania. The answer is Simona Halep. Okay, so she has taken the trophy, and in men's category, we just now saw that it was Novak. Okay, so just memorize these two things. Next one, who among the following has won the gold medal in women's 100 meter at 30th Summer University Games 2019 held in Naples, Italy? So 1 or 2 seconds would be enough for you guys to come out with the answer. And it is Duti Chand, becoming the first Indian woman to win this particular medal. So here it is, her picture. Which of the following country will host the International Shooting Sport Federation Combined World Cup from March 15 to 26, 2020? So the host is going to be India. Again, since it's being hosted by India, it's going to be important. Next, who among the following has become India's first gold medalist at the Kazakhstan President's Cup Boxing Tournament 2019? So it is Shiva Thapa. Moving to the next question, which of the following organization has become the official Team India sponsor for a period of 3 years from 5th September 2019 until 31st March 2022? So this particular organization has replaced Oppo. So the answer is Byju's, a Bangalore-based company. Next one, in which of the following cities will the third edition of Khelo India Youth Games will be held from January 18 to 30, 2020? So very prominent games conducted by the Ministry of Sports. It is Guwahati, okay, the venue. Next question, recently July 2019, in which of the following cities the National Workshop on Statistics and Sustainable Development Goals was held? So the venue for this particular meet, it is Lucknow. Recently, which of the following states has organized a global summit titled Development Partners Conclave to raise money for reconstruction? The answer for this particular question, it is Kerala. Which of the following states in India has ranked first with the highest number of tigers counted to 526? Important one. So the answer is Madhya Pradesh, MP. It has ranked first with the highest number of tigers, which is amounting to 526, right? Okay, next. India has set the target of achieving $5 trillion economy by which year? So this is a very important thing that was highlighted in the economic survey as well. So we also saw the real GDP growth rate that is required to achieve $5 trillion economy. The answer is 2024-25. So I can see people coming out with the answer. So guys, just let me know if everything is going fine. All of you need to participate. Come out with the answers of the questions. Next one, in the Union Budget 2019-20, the overdraft facility for every verified self-help group member with Jan Dhan account announced was how much? What was the overdraft facility? And the answer for this particular question, it is 5,000 rupees was the overdraft facility. Fiscal deficit target for the year 2019-20 is dash of GDP as per the Union Budget 2019-20. So the targets, okay, specifically fiscal deficit, revenue deficit, effective revenue deficit, all these are very important. So the answer is 3.3% of GDP. Next, as per the Economic Survey 2019, that is 2018-19, India's demographic dividend will peak around the year dash. Okay, so which is the year around which the India's demographic dividend will peak? The answer is 2041. Okay. Next question, guys. Ayushman Bharat National Health Protection Mission provides an annual benefit of how much? So you can see you need to tell per family per year how much it is. So you can take 1 or 2 seconds for this particular question. It is 5 lakh per family per year. Right? Okay. Which of the following has become the first foreign bank to launch operations at Gujarat International Finance Tech City, that is GIFT City? Take 1 or 2 seconds for it. I can see people coming up with the answers. So it is Standard Chartered Bank. The next question, which of the following bank has launched its artificial intelligence interactive assistant named Abhi, A-B-H-I? So it is the Andhra Bank. Next question, which of the following has launched a digital banking platform, InstaBiz, for MSME? And you can see there are close options. The correct answer is a private bank, ICICI Bank. If you remember, we were dealing with a question which said about the robotic arms for which bank has launched it. It was ICICI Bank. You need to keep relating these kind of things to remember various important information. Next comes Dash and Common Service Centers have launched a co-branded small business money bank credit card for small traders and village level entrepreneurs. This is again in association with CSCs, Common Service Centers. The answer for this particular question, it is HDFC Bank. Okay, so moving on, which of the following has launched a medium-term strategy framework known as Utkarsh 2022? So this was in limelight, and you should know the answer for this particular question. It is RBI, Reserve Bank of India, has come out with a medium-term strategy framework which is called Utkarsh 2022. Which of the following government has approved over $900,000 for relief and rehabilitation work in Odisha due to Cyclone Fani? So you can also say that, you know, a question can be Cyclone Fani is related to which of the following states? The answer for this particular question, it is Hong Kong. So it has raised this particular donation for it. With which of the following has Reliance Jio partnered to launch a digital literacy initiative which is named Digital Udan? Again, very close options. The answer is Facebook. So Facebook is the one which has partnered with Reliance Jio, and it is important to know the initiative, literacy initiative, Digital Udan. Which of the following bank has launched a web tool which is named Vasool SOFT? The answer for this particular question, it is Karnataka. So I can see all of you are actively answering, and I want the same kind of participation till the end. So guys, thank you so much that you are constantly coming out with the answers. Next one, which of the following bank has signed an MOU, Memorandum of Understanding, with NIIF to provide a boost to infrastructure financing recently? So the correct answer is SBI, the State Bank of India. Next question, which of the following is a revised general provident fund GPF rate effective from July 1st, 2019? Very close options. Usually this is a case going to be in the examination as well. So the answer is 7.9%. Okay, so this is a revised GPF rate and it is effective from July 1st, 2019. Next one, as per the Union Budget 2019-20, how much investment is required in railway infrastructure during 2018 to 2030? So how much lakh crore is the investment that is required? The answer is 50 lakh crore. Moving on to the next question. Jal Jeevan Mission aims to achieve Har Ghar Jal, piped water supply to all rural households by which year? So this is the target year. So whenever there's an initiative, we need to be aware about the target year. That's very important. So the answer is 2024. Moving to the next question, as per the Union Budget 2019, one woman per self-help group is to be eligible for a loan up to how much under Mudra scheme? The answer for this particular question, it is 1 lakh, okay? This is the eligibility, the limit that is being set. Next, E2020, an initiative of WHO, that is World Health Organization, is related to which of the following? It's an important initiative which deals with the elimination of malaria. Okay, so you can see it's E2020, that is achieve malaria elimination by 2020 in 21 countries. So that is what this particular initiative is all about. You can also talk about the headquarters of WHO, that also can be a probable revision. Next, recently Rio Tinto Group has announced to close world's biggest diamond mine. So in each of the following countries, the world's biggest diamond mine is located. Okay, the answer for this particular question, it is Australia. Next one, as per the All India Tiger Estimate 2018, the count of tigers in India has risen 2. So this is again too much tricky. So the answer for this particular question, it is 2967. So you can see the answer and try attempting it. Coming to the next question, as per the report which is released by the Global Footprint Network, the Earth Overshoot Day for the year 2019 is dash. So either in the month of July or August, you can take a minute, a second or two and give me the correct answer. It is July 29th. So that is declared as the Earth Overshoot Day for the year 2019. Next, the recently launched Jal Shakti Abhiyan is a campaign for what? So it's quite predictable. The answer is easy. So the answer for this particular question, it is water conservation. So Jal Shakti Abhiyan is a campaign for water conservation. 190th question, working on a warmer planet is a report released by which of the following organization? So you can see the options are very close. Working on a warmer planet, this can go wrong because the option is unconventional. It is International Labour Organization. So ILO has released this particular report, working on a warmer planet. Which of the following card has a tagline of One Nation, One Card? So this, the correct answer for it is National Common Mobility Card, right? So I can see people coming in with their answers. So let me know if the speed is fine, guys. We can modify it according to whether you're able to answer the questions or not. So let's move on. The next question, Jal Marg Vikas Project is related to which of the following national waterways? Okay, so very close, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the correct answer for this is National Waterways 1. Moving on. In the Union Budget 2019-20, an outlay of rupees 10,000 crore for 3 years was approved for Phase 2 of FAME scheme. So this scheme is related to what? So basically, we are talking about FAME scheme here. So it is something related to moving towards a greener world, greener India. And the answer is electric vehicles. So when you talk about FAME scheme, it is nothing but faster adoption and manufacturing of hybrid and electric vehicles. Next question, as per the announcements made in the Union Budget 2019-20, SEBI is to consider raising threshold for minimum public shareholding in listed companies from 25% to what percentage? So again, important announcements being made in the Union Budget. So think about the answer. It is 35%, right? So it has been increased from 25 to 35%. They're considering it to be increased. Next question. Which of the following is the objective of Study in India campaign launched by the Indian government recently? So let's see the answer for this particular question. So it seems very close, and the correct option is to make India a global hub of higher education. That is the right answer. Recently, okay, the answer is already displayed for this. Sorry about that. Recently, which of the following persons has been appointed as a Secretary of Overseas Indian Affairs? It is Vikas Swaroop. Okay, so the answer was already there. I made it easier for you. Next one, angel tax issue is related to which of the following? This has been in news and I guess it's an easy one for you guys. Still try guessing. Maybe you might go wrong here. The answer for this particular question, it is startups. So angel tax issue is associated with startups. Next question, as a measure to boost electric vehicles, the Union Budget 2019-20 announced additional income tax deduction of how much on interest paid on electric vehicle loans? This is important. You need to tell me the additional income tax deduction. The answer for this particular question, it is 1.5 lakh. So this is the additional income tax deduction that has been announced on interest paid on electric vehicle loans. Next question, how many houses are to be provided to eligible beneficiaries under the second phase 2019-20 to 21-22 of Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen? So you need to see the options. These are quite close and the correct answer is 1.95 crore. So these are the houses that are to be provided, these many number to the eligible beneficiaries under a very famous scheme, Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen. How many toilets have been constructed under the Swachh Bharat Mission since 2nd of October 2014? This is again important. The correct answer is 9.16 crore. So guys, here we complete 100 questions for today, right? And there are so many more to go. So let's see how many of you are going to be there till the end with us for this complete session. And it's really appreciable that I can see most of you are coming out with your answers in the chat section below. So keep doing this and we'll definitely go till the end today. So let's start the month of June 2019. So before I start the month of June 2019, do let us know if the speed is fine, the session is going okay, you're able to make up with the pace that we are following. So quickly feedback so that I can continue with the same pace for the questions of June 2019 as well. So this particular session is really going to be helpful for all those who have studied already, and you can come here and revise your questions. So we are done with September, August and July. Now we're going to start with June 2019. So we're going to have 200 questions here. Quickly we'll be doing that. Okay. So I can see good speed. Okay. Speed is okay. Okay. Faster, slow, speed is fine. Okay, so I can see that most of you a little bit of mixed here. Okay, so I'll try to go a little bit faster. Okay, and then we'll move on. Okay, fine. So let's move on. So the first question for June 2019, so be with us, let's do this, fine. So how much amount of monthly pension will be given to small and marginal farmers under the new Pradhan Mantri Kisan Pension Yojana? So you can see this is a very prominent scheme. Okay, so Pradhan Mantri Kisan Pension Yojana, the answer for this particular question, it is 3000 rupees. Okay. And the next question, which of the following persons was the head of the committee that recently submitted the draft national education policy? So again, whenever there are any committees formed, you need to know the head person of that. The options are very, very close and familiar. The answer for this particular question is Dr. K. Kasturi Rangan. Okay. So here it is his picture. Which of the following institutes has secured top position among Indian institutions in QS World Ranking University Rankings 2020? The answer for this particular question, it is IIT Bombay, right? So this has secured the top position. Next one, as per the National Sample Survey Office Periodic Labor Force Survey, PLFS of the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, India's unemployment rate has risen to dash in 2017-18. So the answer for this particular question, it is 6.1%. So that is the percentage to which India's unemployment has risen. Okay, just mark this particular question, it's important. Which of the following is the theme for the 5th International Day of Yoga 2019? So you can see very close. The answer is climate action. For Ministry of Ayush, theme is yoga for heart. Okay, so these are two important things that you can note down. Next, International Day of Yoga is celebrated annually on which of the following days to raise global awareness about the benefits of the ancient Indian practice? So, it is celebrated on 21st of June. So, this is again very simple. This was all over the news. Next question, on the 5th edition of International Yoga Day, Prime Minister Narendra Modi hosted a grand event at Prabhat Tara Ground in which of the following cities? So it was again related to the International Yoga Day that was being held. The answer is Ranchi, Jharkhand. So it took place in Ranchi. Next, which of the following High Court has recently ruled that animals and birds have legal rights like humans and declared citizens the guardians of animal kingdom? Very important announcement being done, and the answer is Punjab and Haryana. So Punjab and Haryana High Court has come out with a directive that animals and birds have legal rights like humans. Central government has recently reconstituted how many cabinet committees in India? Very close options, and it is 8. 6 cabinet committees has been reconstituted and 2 new cabinet committees has been formed. So it is 8 in total. Which of the following are the 2 new cabinet committees which have been constituted by the government of India? And the answer is 2 and 3. So it's cabinet committee on investment and growth. It is cabinet committee on employment and skill development. Next, which of the following will head the newly constituted Cabinet Committee on Parliamentary Affairs? So we were talking about cabinet committees. So the answer for this particular question, it is Amit Shah. So he'll be heading the newly constituted Cabinet Committee on Parliamentary Affairs. Next, which of the following is the chairperson of National Institution for Transforming India, Niti Aayog? So Niti Aayog replaced the Planning Commission in the year 2015. So it's a think tank basically. A decentralized approach is being followed there. The answer for this particular question, it is Narendra Modi, our Prime Minister. In which of the following states, India's Dinosaur Museum cum park was recently inaugurated? So you can see which state. Just 1 or 2 seconds would be more than enough to answer it. It is Gujarat in Mahisagar district, specific if you be. So India's Dinosaur Museum cum park opened in Gujarat. So here it is. Which of the following countries will cooperate with India to set up a National Maritime Heritage Museum at Lothal in Gujarat? So the answer for this particular question, it is Portugal. Coming to the next question, which of the following is the first political outfit from the northeastern region to get the status of national party recently? So this was again in news, it's an important question out here. The answer for it is National People's Party, NPP. Next question, railway agency of which of the following countries has entered into tripartite agreement with Indian Railway Station Development Corporation to support the railway station development program in India? So we are talking about which country is it? So the correct answer for this particular question, it is France. Okay. Which of the following becomes the first state in India to have village with all solar kitchens? So which of the following state has become the first state in India? So to have a village that has solar kitchens, the answer is Madhya Pradesh, and it is Bancha village in Betul district to be very specific. In which of the following cities, G20 finance ministers and central bank governors meeting was held recently? So you can see the correct answer is Fukuoka, it's Japan. A first of its kind Gandhi Cycle Rally for Peace was organized by the Indian Embassy in Dash as part of the celebrations to mark the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. So you need to tell me the answer. I can see 1 or 2 seconds are more than enough. I'll just be pausing so that you get time to give me the answer. It is Saudi Arabia. Okay, next, recently in June 2019, in which of the following places Central India's first Sikh museum was inaugurated? So which was that particular location? It is Raipur in Chhattisgarh. So here Central India's first Sikh museum was inaugurated. Who among the following persons is the head of the 5-member panel which was constituted to examine subcategorization of OBCs, other backward classes? The answer is G. Rohini. So this is the person who is heading the 5-member panel. The picture is here. As per periodic labor force survey, the female labor force participation rate in India is how much? Again, important one. We also saw previously the unemployment rate that was also there. One other question here, it is 23.3%. So the female labor force participation rate in India, 23.3% is the correct one. As per the periodic labor force survey 2017-18, which of the following states has the lowest female labor force participation rate in India? So we are talking about the lowest female labor force participation rate. The answer being Bihar. Who among the following will chair the committee formed to work out the modalities and methodology of the implementation of next revision of pension under one rank, one pension scheme? So you can see the options on your screen, and it is Sanjeev Mittal, the head of the Controller General of Defense Accounts. This also can be a probable question, so make sure you know this. Which of the following persons will chair the 5-member committee constituted by the Union Government of India to review the existing framework of LPG marketing in India? So we are having a lot of questions regarding the head of the committees or the chair of the committees. So the answer is Kirit Parekh. So you can see the picture of him here. So which of the following countries has hosted the Kimberley Process Intersessional Meeting 2019 from June 17 to 21? It is Mumbai. So India is the chair of the Kimberley Process Certification Scheme for 2019. So the next question, the 20th meeting of the Financial Stability and Development Council was held in New Delhi under the chairmanship of which of the following persons? Again, we are seeing a question which talks about a person heading a particular committee. It is Nirmala Sitharam, Union Minister of Finance and Corporate Affairs. Next one, which of the following is the time period of extension given to the tenure of National Anti-Profiteering Authority in 35th Goods and Services Tax Council meeting? So the answer is 2 years. Coming to the next one, in which of the following states the world's largest multi-stage, multi-purpose scheme, Kaleshwaram Lift Irrigation Project was inaugurated? This is important, KLIP. So you can take 1 or 2 seconds to answer it. It is Telangana. So Telangana has become hosted or has got the privilege to see the world's largest multi-stage, multi-purpose scheme. Which of the following states has released a flood hazard atlas for efficient management of flood in the state? So it is Odisha. Which of the following organizations has released the second edition of Healthy States Progressive India report recently? So this is a very famous important report that has been released. So there can be a doubt between Niti Aayog and Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. The answer is Niti Aayog. As I told you, the think tank which has replaced Planning Commission in the year 2015. Which of the following state has topped among the larger states for overall performance on health indicators in the Niti Aayog report title, Healthy States Progressive India? So the state that has led it is Kerala. It has topped among the larger states for overall performance on health indicators. Which of the following countries has set up Imphal Peace Museum in India to mark the 75th anniversary of the Battle of Imphal in Manipur? It is Japan. Next question, under which of the following scheme, the Department of School Education and Literacy is providing self-defense training for girls in schools? A very important scheme, and the answer for this particular question is Samagra Shiksha. So under this scheme, you can see the Department of School Education and Literacy is providing self-defense training for girls in schools. Which of the following persons has been recently appointed as India's representative in the Council of International Civil Aviation Organization? So we are talking about important announcements here. So I can see most of you are coming out with the answers and still joining with us till the end, and that's great, guys. Very appreciable. So the answer for it is Shefali Juneja. So the next one, who among the following has chaired the Beekeeping Development Committee that submitted its report recently? It is Bibek Debroy, a very prominent name frequently. You can see his picture here. Next, which of the following persons is the head of the committee recently formed for better coordination among the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas, the Ministry of Environment and Forest, and the state governments? It is PK Sinha. Next one, which of the following countries has signed an agreement with Bhagwan Mahavir Viklang Sahitya Samiti Jaipur to provide financial and technical assistance for research and development in the area of prosthetic limbs? So again, important initiative being taken. It is the country of South Korea. Next question, in which of the following states or union territories lies Kalu Police Station, which was ranked as India's best police station in the rankings of police stations for 2018, which was released by the Home Ministry? And the state or the union territory where it is, the state of Rajasthan, specifically talking about the district, it is Bikaner district. Next one, which of the following persons is the head of a group formed for ensuring inter-ministerial coordination on resolving issues related to e-commerce? It is Ramesh Abhishek. This is the correct answer. Next one, in which of the following places the 23rd Sindhu Darshan Festival 2019 has been recently celebrated? We are talking about Sindhu Darshan Festival. So guys, please do write your answers in the comment section. Do let me know if the speed is too fast or too slow so that I can accordingly maintain the pace. You need to get a chance to answer as well. And the answer for this particular question, it is Leh. Okay. Next one, the government has recently set up an 18-member working group for the revision of the current series of WPI Wholesale Price Index under the chairmanship of which of the following? So it is again related to the head of a committee and the answer is Ramesh Chand. Okay, so guys, do write your answers in the comment section. Participate actively here. Next one, in which of the following institutes Center for Inland and Coastal Maritime Technology is being set up? So you can see the university's name there. So the answer for this particular question, okay, it is IIT Kharagpur. So guys, I'm getting a feedback wherein the speed is too much. So I will be slowing down a bit, okay, so that you guys get a chance to answer. So I'll be giving you 2 seconds of gap after I read the question, okay. So coming to the next one, Go Tribal campaign was recently launched by the Ministry for Tribal Affairs. What was the objective of this particular campaign, which is Go Tribal campaign launched by the Ministry for Tribal Affairs? You can see the options and the correct answer for this particular question. It is promote tribal arts and crafts. Go Tribal campaign is related to this particular initiative or objective. So the next question, equip a 5-year vision plan is related to which of the following fields? So the correct answer for this particular question, it is education. So equip a 5-year vision plan is related to the field of education. If you see the full form of it, it is education, quality upgradation and inclusion program. You can also get full forms in your paper. That's also important. So note that down. Next question, which of the following organizations has proposed a national mission on natural language translation to make research and teaching resources on science and technology accessible to all in 2 languages? So this is something which is a unique initiative out here. It is brought out by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, MeeTee. Okay, the next one, which of the following persons was the head of high-level advisory group to boost India's share and importance in global merchandise and services trade? So you can see that we are talking about appointments, again, head of the committees or panel. This is again important. So it is Surjit S. Bhalla. So he is the head of the high-level advisory group. Elephant bonds recommended by the high level advisory group headed by Dr. Surjit Bhalla are associated with which of the following? So we have just now seen a question regarding that. So you can see the options on your screen. The correct one is long-term infrastructure. So when you talk about elephant bonds, it is associated with long-term infrastructure. Next one, which of the following places has become the southernmost city in the world? So yes, it is important. Recently in news, you can see the options. It is Puerto Williams, which is in Chile, right? Next one, AWARE, an online tool developed by WHO, that is the World Health Organization, is related to which of the following? So one of all the burning issues you can see in your options. The correct one is antimicrobial resistance. So AWARE is an online tool which is related to antimicrobial resistance. It is developed by World Health Organization. For which of the following states, Asian Development Bank has approved $350 million loan to rehabilitate and upgrade state highways and major district roads. So whenever we talk about a particular loan, we need to go to the detailing of to which state it is being offered. It is the state of Chhattisgarh, right? Okay. Which of the following financial service companies has recently launched Sabse Khas loan scheme for two-wheeler customers? So the name of the loan is Sabse Khas loan and it is catering to two-wheeler customers. It is L&T Finance. Which of the following is the rank of India in the recently released Sustainable Development Goals Gender Equality Index? Important, again, India's rank in these indices can be a probable question in the exam. And the correct answer is 95. So India stands at the position of 95 in the recently released SDG Gender Equality Index. Which of the following persons has become the first expat to get the UAE's first gold card permanent residency? You can see the names there on your screen. So it is M.A. Yusuf Ali. So this particular personality has become the first expatriate to get the UAE's first gold card permanent residency. Here it is. Which of the following cities has been ranked as the most traffic congested in the world? Okay. So it is Mumbai. So India taking the lead. It is the most traffic congested in the world. It's not in India only. In which of the following places the G20 ministerial meeting on trade and digital economy was held on 8th and 9th of June 2019? It is Tsukuba, that is in Japan. Recently in June 2019, which of the following African nation was suspended by African Union Peace and Security Council? So this was regarding a suspension that was made by the African Union Peace and Security Council. It is Sudan. Okay, so the country of Sudan. Which of the following countries has launched the first Arctic tourist train service? It is Russia. Moving on to the next question, which of the following persons was conferred with the Maldives' highest honor, Rule of Nishan Izzuddin, recently? So there are so many countries coming out and giving their highest civilian honors to prominent personalities in India. So we need to be aware of the same. It is Mr. Narendra Modi, our Prime Minister. Which of the following countries has recognized forests as living entities on the World Environment Day on June 5, 2019? So the World Environment Day celebrated on June 5, 2019. It is El Salvador, so it has become the country that has recognized forests as living entity. Which of the following countries has topped in the Global Peace Index 2019 released by the Australian Think Tank Institute for Economics and Peace? So the country that has taken the top position, it is Iceland. Okay. Coming to the next question, so which of the following is the rank of India in the Global Peace Index 2019 released by the Institute of Economics and Peace recently? We just now saw which country topped it. So now you need to tell me the answer, where does India stand in the ranking? The correct one is 141. It is out of 163 countries that have been ranked in total. So out of it, you can see India takes the position 141. Moving on, which of the following countries will ban single-use plastics from 2021 with the goal zero plastic waste from coast to coast? So you need to tell me the answer. I can see people are answering and they are coming out with answers for most of the questions. All of you guys there in the chat, do come out with your answers. The answer for this particular question, Canada. Next one, in which of the following cities the Shanghai Cooperation Organization Summit 2019 was held? SCO 2019 Summit. It is Bishkek in Kyrgyzstan. Which of the following countries has released the new banknotes of 10,000, 20,000 and 50,000 denominations for racketing hyperinflation, which eroded the currency's value? So guys, the answer is Venezuela. So this is a country that has released the new banknotes of 10,000, 20,000 and 50,000 denominations. Which of the following organizations has recently released the 26th edition of the Population Estimates and Projection Report, the World Population Prospects 2019 highlights? Come out with the answers for this, and the correct one, it is United Nations, that is Department of Economic and Social Affairs, to be very specific. This report is also important, the World Population Prospects 2019. The next one, as per the World Population Prospects 2019 highlights, India is set to surpass China as the world's most populous country by which year? So we were talking about this report, and now we are talking about a specific information given regarding India in this particular report. It is 2027. As per the World Population Prospects 2019 highlights, world's population is expected to increase by dash persons in the next 30 years. So we are still continuing with the World Population Prospects 2019 report. So first we saw an information related to India, and now we are talking about world population. The correct answer is 2 billion, from 7.7 billion currently to 9.7 billion in 2015. Okay, so this is a projection here. There is some mistake in this particular question. Just look at the answer, which says 2 billion. Next, as per the World Population Prospects 2019 highlights, by which year will the demographic dividend of India peak? So the answer is 2047. Remember, we saw a question which was related to economic survey. According to economic survey 2018-19, in India, the demographic dividend will peak by 2041. Okay, and here, according to the World Population Prospects, it would peak by 2047. Next, India has for the first time granted financial support of $15 million for the African Union Summit, scheduled to be held in Dash in July 2019. It is Niger. Next question, which of the following organizations is planning to launch a cryptocurrency named Libra? So just take 1 or 2 seconds and give me an answer for it. Very close options. Cryptocurrency, which is called Libra. So the answer is Facebook. Which of the following countries has recently discovered its first iron ore mine? It is very recent, and it is Bangladesh. Which of the following has become the first Arab country to receive full membership of the Financial Action Task Force recently? So it's become the first Arab nation. That is important. Focus on that. Answer is Saudi Arabia. Moving on, GOAML, an anti-money laundering platform, was recently launched by which of the following countries? It is United Arab Emirates, UAE. International rating agency Fitch Ratings certified long-term IDRs to 6 banks with the BBB a stable outlook. In IDRs, D stands for what? So the answer is default, okay, issuer default ratings. Recently in June 2019, which of the following banks has joined hands with Multilateral Investment Guarantee Agency to expand development finance in Asia and Pacific to increase the flow of private sector investment? The answer is Asian Development Bank, ADB. So you can immediately recall the headquarters of ADB as well. That can be a probable static question as in your examination. As per the Reserve Bank of India, over 6,800 cases of bank fraud involving an unprecedented dash have been reported in 2018-19. The answer is 71,500 crore. The Reserve Bank of India has observed Financial Literacy Week 2019 from, and the answer is June 3 to 7, and the theme for this year is farmers and how they benefit by being a part of the formal banking system. Next, MDR was in news recently. What does it stand for? Very easy question. It is merchant discount rate. And initially, we also saw that MDR rates have been decreased. So that was also a question that we discussed in the very first session. If you can recollect, even write that in the comment section below. As per the revised large exposures framework norms, the sum of all the exposure values of a bank to a single counterparty must not be higher than dash of the bank's available eligible capital base at all times. So it is 20%. Which of the following state government has signed a loan agreement worth $287 million with World Bank for promoting the state's health system reform program? So again, whenever you talk about loan agreements being given by important international financial institutions, you need to know about which state it is catering to. The answer is Tamil Nadu. Next one, guys, Dash unveiled the Digital Sakhi program aimed at training over 40,000 people on digital financial inclusion in Tamil Nadu. So you can see the options on your screens. Take 1 or 2 seconds and come out with the answer for it. It is L&T Financial Services. Which of the following banks has recently launched a center in Bengaluru to provide business solutions exclusively to startups and the MSME sector? So I'll just be waiting so that you get the room to give me an answer for this particular question. It is ICICI Bank. So the next one, how many days are given for the lenders to review a borrower account after default as per the new NPA guidelines, prudential framework for resolution of stressed assets released by the RBI? So how many days have been given for the lenders to review a borrower account? It is 30 days, 1 month, right? Recently, in June 2019, which of the following banks has conducted the first e-auction of forest produce in Maharashtra under its Tech for Change initiative? So take 1 or 2 seconds. It is the Yes Bank. So the Tech for Change initiative is associated with Yes Bank. You can just memorize this particular thing. The Reserve Bank of India on June 6 announced the rollout of a foreign exchange trading platform for retail participants. It has been developed by which of the following? It is the Clearing Corporation of India, CCIL. So let's move on. So guys, at the end of this particular session, we'll be providing you the PDF of this particular session as well. You can download that from the Telegram channel of EduTap. Okay, which of the following entity has launched India's first mutual fund side pocket recently to set aside its troubled investment in Divan Housing Finance Limited? The correct answer is Tata Mutual Fund. As per the Benchmarking India's Payment Systems report released by the Reserve Bank of India, how much did the share of e-money in India's payment systems grow in 2017? How much percentage did it grow in the year 2017? So quickly give me an answer for this. So the correct one is 21.5%. It was 0.8% in the year 2012 and now it is 21.5%. Moving on to the next one, the Reserve Bank of India has recently revised the leverage ratio for domestic systematically important banks to how much in a bid to help them expand their lending activities. So all of you give me the answer for this particular question. So the answer is 4%. It is 3.5% for other banks. And for domestic systematically important banks, it is 4%. Which of the following banks has become the first to introduce repo-linked home loan product from July 1, 2019? It is State Bank of India. Who among the following was the head of a committee which came out with inter-creditor agreement for resolution of stressed assets in 2018? So you need to tell me the name of the personality out here. It is Sunil Mehta, according to the Sashakt Committee. You can see his picture. Which of the following organizations has launched the unique proprietary tool named My Protection Quotient to ensure financial protection? It is Max Life Insurance Limited. Next one, who among the following heads the committee of experts set up by RBI to reduce prices for customers on ATM transactions with a broader objective to improve rural penetration of teller machines? So I can see people are coming out with the answers. So the correct one here, it is V.G. Kannan. Which of the following banks has signed a bank assurance corporate agency agreement on June 1, 2019 with Max Bupa, a standalone health insurer, Sahi? And it is IDBI Bank Limited. Next one, which of the following fintech startup has partnered with Digital Insurance to offer first of its kind EMI insurance to the company's 5 million customers? So these names are quite familiar: MobiKwik, Zest Money, Lending Cart. The correct option is Zest Money. Next one, which of the following banks accounted for the highest number of fraud cases between 2008-9 and 2018-19 as per the latest data released by the RBI? So I'll just give you 1 or 2 seconds. And guys, do let me know if the pace is fast so that I can slow down and you can get chance to answer. So the correct option for this particular question, it is ICICI Bank. Moving on, recently in July 2019, the government has approved a project to build India-based neutrino observatory in which of the following states? You can see all are southern states except Maharashtra. Yeah, southern states only. And southwestern states as well. So the answer is Tamil Nadu. Next one, which of the following has launched Selfie Wala KYC, Know Your Customer feature for first time mutual fund investors? So you can see the options. It is Funds Bazaar. So this is the right one. Okay, so next question. Which of the following states has received Rs 1,650 crore from Asian Development Bank for infrastructure development such as piped water supply, underground drainage, etc. in its 7 district headquarter towns? So again, you can see that we are talking about a financial institution, Asian Development Bank. So yes, the correct option out here, it is Tripura. So this particular state is the one which has received Rs 1,650 crore from ADB. Who among the following headed an expert committee set up by RBI in January 2019 to suggest long-term solutions for the economic and financial sustainability of the MSME sector? So again, we have seen a lot of questions which were related to the head of the committee, so that's important. So the answer is UK Sinha. So again, one more thing. So we have completed 100 questions for the month of June 2019 as well. So let us continue this session. And guys, as I can see that I'm getting mixed responses regarding the speed. So I'm trying my best to form a balance between not being fast and not being slow as well. So let's see if I can cope up to your expected speed right here. So let's take a break for 1 or 2 seconds and then move on to the 101 question. I can understand that the questions are too much and you might think that it is going a little bit off overboard, but I think, guys, it's worth it. Let's just sit for a few more minutes and let's just begin. Yeah, thank you so much. I think someone is addressing me as Didi, and that's so cute. So Sebi will be out soon, do not worry, right? So let's start the next question. Okay, fine. So let's move on. Okay, enough of break, I think, and let's take the next question. So UK Sinha led expert committee on micro, small and medium enterprises has recommended the doubling of cap on collateral free loans to dash from dash. Okay, so you need to tell me, see the options quickly, come back now. It is rupees 20 lakh and rupees 10 lakh. So UK Sinha led expert committee on micro, small and medium enterprises has recommended the doubling of cap on the collateral free loans to 20 lakh. Earlier it was 10 lakh. Okay. So just note down this particular answer. Okay, so next one. Which of the following has signed an MOU with National Health Authority to train 15,000 state and district personnel and Pradhan Mantri Arogya Mitras to streamline the delivery of health services under Ayushman Bharat scheme? So you can see the options are quite different. So let's see what is the answer for it. It is ICICI Foundation. Which of the following e-commerce firms has revamped its seller financing program Growth Capital to enable the financial inclusion of MSMEs which operate online? So again, very close options on your screens. It is Amazon, Flipkart, Myntra, Snapdeal and IndiaMart. Answer is Flipkart, an e-commerce firm which has revamped its seller financing program Growth Capital. The National Housing Bank has recently revised the capital adequacy ratio norms for housing finance companies to how much by March 2020? The percentages are quite close. Have a look at them. So the answer is 13%. So 14% by March 2021 and 15% by March 2022. Okay, so these are the percentages that you need to keep in mind. Next one, which of the following banks has recently raised 300 crore through Basel III compliant bonds on private placement basis? It is Federal Bank. So banks in India have to comply with the internationally agreed Basel III norms by March 31st, 2020. Government of which of the following states has recently signed a loan agreement with World Bank to improve the management capacity of its urban local bodies? So you need to tell me the state. I'll just give you a 2 second gap so that you can come out with the answer. Type in the comment section below. The answer is Jharkhand. How much amount of stressed asset fund has been suggested by UK Sinha led expert committee for domestic MSMEs relief to small businesses hurt by demonetization and the goods and services tax? The answer is 5,000 crore. Next, which of the following state governments has signed an agreement with the World Bank to provide $31.58 million for the improvement of financial systems and better utilization of development resources in the state? So again, whenever there is an international financial organization, we are always keen about which state government has received loan from it. The answer is Uttarakhand. Next, which of the following organizations has issued a framework for the setting up of financial benchmark administrator to administer significant benchmarks in the markets for financial instruments? So we are talking about financial benchmark administrator, FBA. You can see all regulatory bodies out here. And the answer is Reserve Bank of India, RBI. Which of the following companies has launched shampoo sachet concept to offer mini medical insurance products with premiums as low as rupees 20 in partnership with health insurer Max Bupa? And so you need to tell me which company is it. So the answer is MobiQuick. Okay. Next one, which of the following companies has launched a tool, Anti-Money Laundering Express Edition, to assist banks to detect, investigate and report suspected money laundering and terrorist financing activity? So very close options on your screens available. It is Oracle. On the 125th anniversary of Olympic Games, International Olympic Committee has formally opened its new headquarters in which of the following places? So IOC's official headquarters would be Luasen in Switzerland. Next one, which of the following state governments has signed a loan agreement of $328 million with the World Bank to help improve the quality and responsiveness of public health services in the state? So we are talking about which state government is it? The answer is Andhra Pradesh. The Reserve Bank of India has set an average base rate of how much for non-banking financial companies and microfinance institutions to be charged from their customers for the quarter beginning July 1, 2019. Answer is 9.18%. Next, which of the following cryptocurrency exchanges has terminated its digital asset trading services and other crypto-related operations in India, citing regulatory uncertainty and deception recently in the month of June 2019? So these are the options, and the correct answer for this particular question, it is CoinEx. So it's a cryptocurrency exchange. Which of the following state government has signed a loan agreement with the World Bank to build the capacity to better manage its highways? So again, you can see whenever we are talking about an international financial institution, we are coupling it with the state government. So guys, tell me the answers. Please write that down in the comment section below. It is Rajasthan. Which of the following banks has signed a loan agreement of $250 million for the first Resilient Kerala program to enhance Kerala's resilience against the impact of natural disasters and climate change? So you can see all the important organizations in the option. You can also quickly remind yourself about the headquarters of each. And it is World Bank, the correct answer. Which of the following banks has partnered with Centrum Wealth Management Limited to form a private limited joint venture providing wealth management services to its clients? So the correct answer for this particular question is the Karur Vyasa Bank. So guys, please do keep mentioning the answers in the comment section below, and tell me if you want more time. I can see very slow, very fast. So there are different opinions being given. So let me try to find a balance to keep all of you satisfied. The union government has met the fiscal deficit target of Dash for the financial year 2018-19. Again, important targets, fiscal deficit. It is 3.4%, and for the financial year 20, the target is 3.3%. Okay, here we are talking about 2018-19 and 2019-20. Which of the following organizations has recently become India's most profitable PSU after surpassing Indian Oil Corporation? This is an important feat that has taken place. So the answer for this particular question is ONGC, Oil and Natural Gas Corporation. Next one, which of the following countries has been terminated from availing benefits of generalized system of preferences of USA recently? You can see the options on your screen. I'll give you 2 seconds to answer this. It is India. So India has been terminated from availing benefits of GPS, Generalized System of Preferences of USA. Indian Oil, Bharat Petroleum and Hindustan Petroleum will jointly lay the world's largest LPG pipeline between Gujarat and which state? So the answer is Uttar Pradesh. So this 2,757 kilometer long pipeline will connect Kandla in Gujarat to Gorakhpur in Uttar Pradesh. So they can either ask you the question that you can see on your screen, or the other way also can be asked, where Gorakhpur in Uttar Pradesh is given and you need to identify Kandla in Gujarat. Next, the report Global Economic Prospect has been recently published by which of the following organizations recently in the month of June 2019? So quite close, the options can be confusing for you guys. It is World Bank. Okay, so the World Bank releases Global Economic Prospect report. Which of the following organizations has launched the index titled Fiscal Performance Index to assess the state and central budgets? So we are talking about a very important index, Fiscal Performance Index. It is a Confederation of Indian Industry, CII. Which of the following has become India's first ever project to receive the power generated from a waste to energy plant recently in the month of June 2019? It is Delhi Metro Rail Corporation, DMRC. Which of the following union ministries has signed an MOU with SEBI to tackle rising instances of fraud? Again, very close options. It is Ministry of Corporate Affairs, MCA. India's first type approval certificate for Bharat State 6 norms for the two-wheeler segment has been recently released by which of the following? The answer is International Center for Automotive Technology, ICAT. BS6 norms are going to be implemented in India from which of the following dates? Important question. Moving towards greener India, so obviously there are a couple of initiatives that we saw in this particular session as well. So you can see the options. Take 2 seconds. Give me your answer. It is 1st April 2020. BS stands for obviously Bharat Stage. An interactive game show, which is called Confetti, or how is it pronounced, I really don't know, has been launched by which of the following? So take 2 seconds, and the answer for this particular question, it is FT, Facebook. The next question, World Investment Report 2019 has been released recently in the month of June 2019. It is released by which of the following? So important reports, and the organization that released that report is usually asked in the examination. It is United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. How much amount of FDI has been received by India for the year 2018 as per World Investment Report 2019? Important one. It is $42 billion. So how much amount of FDI has been received by India for the year 2019? It is $42 billion. As per the report released by the Fisheries Department in the month of June 2019, India is the second largest fish producing country in the world with dash percentage of global fish production. It is 6.3%. China is the largest producer of fish in the world. Next one, which of the following countries has overtaken China to become India's top goods trading partner in 2018-19 as per the recently released data by Commerce Ministry? So I'll give you 2 seconds so that you can come out with the answer for this particular question. So it is United States of America. So USA has overtaken China to become India's top goods trading partner in 2018-19. Next one, which of the following organizations heads the working group formed by SEBI to review the current framework of margins in the futures and options segment? It is NSE Clearing Limited. Which of the following countries' suspension was ended by the Parliament of the Council of Europe recently by vote, thereby restoring its full rights in the Council? It is Russia. Which of the following entities has signed a contract with Airbus for cabin and cargo design engineering recently in the month of June 2019? It is Tech Mahindra. The periodic labor force survey for 2017-18 has been recently released by which of the following organizations? We have seen this particular survey. We have seen a couple of questions related to it. So the answers are quite close. It is National Sample Survey Organization. NSSO has recently released periodic labor force survey. Who among the following has become the first IAF woman pilot to fly Hawk advanced jet aircraft? It is Mohana Singh. This is her picture. Which of the following state's health department has been conferred with the World Health Organization's Tobacco Control Award for 2019 during the World No Tobacco Day? It is Rajasthan. So Rajasthan has received this prestigious award. Who among the following has been awarded with the highest civilian award of Mexico given to foreigners called as Orden Mexicana del Águila Azteca, Order of the Aztec Eagle? And as I told you, a couple of countries giving its highest awards to our the important personalities from India. The answer for this particular question, it is a former president, it is Pratibha Patil. Which of the following NGOs has bagged the Equator Prize for 2019 by United Nations for its outstanding effort for nature-based solution to climate change and sustainable development? So this is an important one. Kindly mark this particular question. It is Deccan Development Society. It is an NGO based out of the state of Telangana in India. The novel An American Marriage has been authored by which of the following? So take 1 or 2 seconds. I'll give you time so that you can come out with the answer for this particular question. It is Tyree Jones. So An American Marriage, it's authored by Tyree Jones. So Tyree Jones has recently received Women's Prize for Fiction. Okay, so this is again an achievement in itself. This is her picture. You can see the poster of the front page of the book as well. It will help you remember. Who among the following has won the award for Best Featured Actress for Oklahoma? It is Ali Stroker. So she has made history by becoming the first actor to win a Tony Award in a wheelchair. Okay. So you can see here her picture. Looks really inspiring. Brands top 100 most valuable global brand ranking 29 index has been topped by which of the following companies? It's going to be a close call. So see the answer for, let me see if you can guess the answer for this particular question. So it is Amazon. 54th Nanpith Award has been given to which of the following personalities? So quite close again. You can take 2 seconds so that you are able to answer. It is Amitav Ghosh. This is his picture here. Who among the following has been recently inducted into Facebook's Hall of Fame for discovering a WhatsApp bug? This is Zonal Zaugajim, hails from Manipur. So it's again an accomplishment for India. You can see. Which of the following Indian actress has been selected for Danny Kaye Humanitarian Award by United Nations International Children's Fund, UNICEF American Chapter, recently in the month of June 2019? So again a close call. It is Priyanka Chopra. Who among the following has won Bal Sahitya Puraskar 2019 for a history book in English? It is Devika Karyappa. Who among the following has been recently conferred with Save Water Hero Award for raising awareness about water conservation in the city of Pune? So, important awards being discussed. So, I'll just give you 2 seconds so that you guys can come out with the answer for this particular question that you see on your screens. The answer is Makaran Tillu. Which of the following organizations has been awarded with the BBC World Service Global Champion Award 2019? So, important foundations out here. It is the Akshay Patra Foundation, and it's very, very good foundation. It's known for its contribution to midday meal program. And yes. So guys, here we are done with the 150 questions taken from the month of June 2019. So guys, there are more 50 questions left. I really hope the Josh is still high and you are still into this particular session wherein you are going to be giving these answers for the next 50 questions. Let's do it within some 15 to 20 minutes more, and we'll complete this month in itself. So guys, I would really want your cooperation. Only then I'll be able to take the session forward. We are already done with 150 questions of June, as well as questions from July have been completed today. Yes, I can understand. I can see the review that you need to, half of you are saying we need to stop and half of you tomorrow. So let's complete, I guess. Only then tomorrow we'll be able to take up the next month, that is maybe October, we can do a few questions, and May we can complete, and then on 5th we can complete October, plus we can do some questions from economic survey budget, right? So let's do it, I think, right? I want your comments there. I'm not going to start. I'm going to go for a 1 or 2 minutes break. Okay, so, and let's see if you guys are really interested, and then we'll move ahead. I can see the Josh is high, and I really want that to be. Only then we'll be able to do. I'm trying my level best to come out with a balance, because when I read the comments, I can see half of you are saying the pace is fast and half of you are saying it's slow. So to satisfy everyone, I'm trying to take a middle ground here. Okay. So I really want the cooperation from all of you who are there, and then let's go on with that. Thank you so much, guys. I can see many of you encouraging and saying let's go, and it gives us the, you know, energy to let's do it. Okay, fine. So the Josh is very high. We'll go on. Fine, I can see that. Okay, no stopping. Great. Okay, thank God. So you all are with me, not slept until now. So let's move on. Fine, okay. So rukna mana hai. So yes, rukna mana hai. Let's start. Fine, let's carry on, right? Okay. So, okay. The next question. Which of the following has been crowned as Miss India 2019? So tell me the answer. See the options on your screens. Okay, so let's take 1 or 2 seconds out here. So the answer for this particular question, it is Suman Rao. She's from Rajasthan. Okay. So which of the following has been crowned as Miss India 2019? It is Suman Rao from Rajasthan. Great going. Move on to the next question. She looks very pretty. You can see the picture out here, right? Okay. So which of the following states has topped the second edition of United States Green Building Council's list of India's top 10 states that have maximum number of LEED certified green buildings? Okay, the question is too long. So LED stands for Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design. Okay, so the answer for this particular question, it is Maharashtra. So I've given you some few seconds so that you can give me the answer for it. Right, so the next one, headquarters of Financial Action Task Force is in which of the following places? It is Paris, France. Doordarshan India channel is going to be broadcasted in which of the following countries as announced recently? So it's a feat for India. It is Bangladesh and South Korea. Who among the following has won the Red Ink Award for Journalist of the Year 2019? So we have seen a couple of awards today. Maybe just try recollecting them. Okay. And the answer is Rachna Khera. Okay. So she has won for exposing the functioning of UIDAI and its Aadhaar data cache in 2018. So a sensitive issue, data privacy. Next one, which of the following films has become the first Indian film to win Outstanding Artistic Achievement Award at the 22nd Shanghai International Film Festival recently? So you can see the options. First Indian film winning the Outstanding Artistic Achievement Award. The answer is Veil Marangal. It's in Malayalam, right? Sorry if I've pronounced it wrong for all those who know this language. Next one, which of the following Indian politician has been named in the list 100 most influential in UK-India relations, celebrating women released recently? So see the options, take 1 or 2 seconds for you to answer. It is Nirmala Sitaram, a very prominent politician in India. Who among the following has been elected as the external auditor of the World Health Organization recently? So the answer is Rajiv Maharishi. So the the CAG of India. So he has been elected for 4 years, from 2020 to 2023. Who among the following has been recently appointed as the chief of Indian Meteorological Department IMD for a period of 5 years? It is Mrityunjay Mohapatra. So keep this name in mind. Who among the following has been elected as the president of Federation Internationale de Football Association recently? FIFA. Okay. So I know that most of you are football fans here. So you need to tell me who has been elected as the president of FIFA recently. Okay. In the name of football, it is Gianni Infantino. Right. Moving on. Azim Premji has retired in the month of June 2019. He is the founder of which of the following companies? So this is probably simple. We all have heard about him. So it is Wipro. Abhishek Shah has been appointed as the chief marketing officer of which of the following? So take 2 seconds of break and give me an answer for this particular question quickly in the chat section below. It is BharatPay. Who among the following has been appointed as the managing director of India's first international financial services center, GIFT City? Okay, so GIFT City, very often in news for various developments taking place there. It is Tapan Ray. Who among the following has been recently appointed as the interim CVC, Central Vigilance Commissioner? It is Sharad Kumar. Who among the following was the pro-term speaker of the recently elected 17th Lok Sabha? It is Virendra Kumar. Om Birla has been elected as the new speaker of the 17th Lok Sabha. He hails from which of the following states? So this is a pretty simple question. It's all over the news every time he's been addressed. So take your time. Give me an answer for this. It is Rajasthan. So Mr. Om Birla, the speaker of the 17th Lok Sabha, hails from Rajasthan. Who among the following is the new DG, Director General of the Indian Coast Guard? It is Krishna Swami Natarajan. So he is the new Director General of the Indian Coast Guard. Who among the following has been appointed as the new Chief of Research and Analysis Wing RAW for a fixed 2-year term? Samant Kumar Goyal. We have seen a couple of questions related to appointments in this particular session today. What is the name of the new chief of IB, Intelligence Bureau, appointed recently for the tenure of 2 long years? It is Arvind Kumar. Who among the following has been appointed as the first Indian to become the member of International Olympic Committee while heading a National Olympic Committee and an international federation? Okay, as the first Indian, this is again, you can see a feat in itself. So guys, giving you 1 or 2 seconds so that you come out with the answer for this particular question. It is Narendra Batra. Who among the following has been appointed as the MD, Managing Director of the National Housing Bank for a period of 3 years? It is Sardar Kumar Hota. So as I told you, a couple of appointments in this particular session, you need to memorize them. Here is his picture. Siddharth Rawat is associated with which of the following sports? Okay, take 2 seconds and all of you, please write the answer in the comment section below. Keep the Josh high, running. Answer is tennis. He won his maiden title in ITF's men's futures tennis tournament. Okay, so Siddharth Rawat being associated with tennis sport. Who among the following has become the most capped football player, surpassing the former Indian captain Bhaichung Bhutia? So Bhaichung Bhutia, a very prominent name. So it is Sunil Chhetri, right? Again, he has received an award as well. If you guys are with me throughout the session, tell me the award that Sunil Chhetri has won. Okay, we just now saw a question related to that as well. So if you can write down in the comment section, it would be really great. I would get to know if you are attentive and you still are able to recollect. Okay, so tell me what is the award that Sunil Chhetri won. Okay, we have seen that. So moving on to the next question, who among the following has won the 2019 Asian Continental Chess Championship in Xingtai, China in the Blitz event? So you can see the options on your screen, take your time and please do write the answer there. Yeah, I can see Footballer of the Year award for the previous question and that's great, you all remember. Yes, that is true. It is the sports person of the year is not the correct answer. If you recollect who was the sports person of the year, just recollect and then I'll move on forward. It was best footballer. Yeah, and who was the sports person of the year? That also you need to mention. Just try recollecting it. If not possible, you need to recollect, you need to see the PDF again. Okay, fine. So let's move forward now. The answer for this particular question, it is Nihal Sarin, 14-year-old grandmaster, right? Okay, so here he is, a young chap. Which of the following countries has won the Federation International Day Hockey Men's Series Hockey Tournament for the year 2019? The answer for this particular question is India. So great, India has won this particular men's series hockey tournament for the year 2019. Who among the following has won the gold medal in women's 1500 meter at Foxham Grand Prix 2019? Take your time, give me the answer for this particular question. It is PU Chitra. The event has taken place in Sollentuna, Sweden. The names are really tricky. Okay, so next one, who among the following has won bronze medal in women's vault event at 2019 Asian Artistic Gymnastic Championship, Mongolia? Take your time, give me the answer. So it is Pranati Nayak. Women hockey team from which of the following countries has won the FIH Women's Series Finals Hiroshima 2019, Japan? So let's see which team is it. It is India. Again, India doing great at various places. Who among the following has become the India's 63rd Grandmaster? It is Girish A. Kaushik. So he has won the 37th Balaton International Chess Festival in Hungary. Here it is, his picture out there. Indian Navy has recently launched Operation Sankalp in which of the following places? So whenever there is an operation being launched, you need to know about the names of that particular operation. It is Strait of Hormuz. Okay, so Operation Sankalp. Which of the following countries will host 2026 Winter Olympics? So tell me the answer for this particular question. So the answer is Italy. So Italy is going to be the country which will host 2026 Winter Olympics. What is the rank of India in the recently released End of Childhood Index that evaluates countries on the well-being of children? India's rank is 113. Singapore has topped the list. Okay. Swachh Sarvekshan League 2020 will be a dash cleanliness assessment of cities and towns in India. Quarterly. Okay, so it will be released quarterly. This is again important. It has been launched by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Which of the following states have received GI tag for Kolhapuri Chappal recently? Very famous. Two states together have been given the GI tag for it. Right? And the correct answer is Maharashtra and Karnataka. And let me tell you that we have seen a question previously today related to GI tag. It was regarding Rasagulla. So we saw West Bengal was a state that received it first. And after that, it was Odisha that had received the GI tag. Okay, so next one. NASA has planned to launch Dragonfly mission. It is related to which of the following? Dragonfly mission. Much heard of. It is Titan moon of Saturn. World Drug Report 2019 has been released recently by which of the following organization? I'll give you 1 or 2 seconds so that you can come out with the answer. It is United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime. What is the, okay, the answer has come on its own. What is the number of non-permanent members in the UN Security Council? The answer is 10. India is set to become non-permanent member for a 2-year term in 2021-22. Right, so here I've already given you the answer. So let's quickly move on to the next one. Submarine INS Sindhu Veer is going to be handed over by India by which of the following countries, okay, for training purposes. So India is going to be handing over INS Sindhu Veer to which country? So you can see the options out here. Take your time, give me the answer for it. The answer is Myanmar. Food and Nutrition Security Analysis India 2019 has been prepared by which of the following ministries in collaboration with World Food Program? Right? So the options are quite close. There can be a kind of a confusion here. The answer is Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. Recently, India's first proton therapy center has been inaugurated in which of the following places? The answer is Chennai. So, first proton therapy center being inaugurated in Chennai. As per the recent RBI directive, all the data which is related to payment transactions must be stored in India, and such information, if processed abroad, will have to be brought back within how much? How many hours or how many days? Okay, so you can see the options there. Take your time and give me an answer for this particular question. It is 24 hours, one business day is the answer for it. Okay. So guys, all of you, last 9 questions to go. So please do keep writing the answers in the chat section. Let's see till the end if you can maintain that energy. Next, recently Chokhandi Stopa has been declared as a national importance by Archaeological Survey of India. It lies in which of the following states? Okay. So Chokhandi Stopa lies in which state basically is the question. It has been declared to be of national importance by the ASI. So it is Uttar Pradesh. That is the right answer. UP. Which of the following has been set as a target year by ISRO to have its own space station? Okay, this is important. So you can see the options very close. So guys, all of you answering this 193rd question. Come on. Last 7 questions to go, and all of you answer, whoever is there in this session right now, need to give this answer. It is 2030. Next, which of the following country's satellite Ravana 1 was recently launched from into the orbit from the International Space Station? So the answer for this particular question, it is Sri Lanka. It is the first satellite of Sri Lanka. Okay, so this is important. Just mark this particular answer. Which of the following has launched a data platform of integrated database or infrastructure products aimed at enhancing the efficiency of infrastructure development in India? Again, very close options out there. Take your time. Give me an answer for it. So it is IIT Madras. This is the correct answer. Which of the following has signed a technical assistance agreement with the Airports Authority of India to jointly develop a comprehensive 10-year roadmap for modernizing air traffic management in India? So the answer for this, which of the following has signed a technical assistance agreement with the Airports Authority of India? And the answer is Boeing. Okay, tell me which country is Boeing from, like which country owns it? Okay, so next one, what is the theme of the World Environment Day celebrated on June 5, 2019? So take your time and come out with the answer for it. Okay, so the answer for this particular question, it is Beat Air Pollution. Host country was China. So the theme is Beat Air Pollution. Okay guys, the 198th question, the first ever World Food Safety Day adopted by the United Nations General Assembly in December 2018 was celebrated on which date? Okay, quite close, the dates can be confusing, so nothing to understand, just memorizing. 7th June 2019, the theme is Food Safety Everyone's Business. Yes, true, Food Safety Everyone's Business, it should be, right, and rightly is the theme. The Quadrilateral Security Dialogue is an informal strategic grouping consisting of India and which of the following countries? So yes, Quadrilateral Security Dialogue, most often, much often in news. Okay. So take your time, give me an answer for this particular question. It is US, Japan and Australia. Okay, so the last question for today, guys, the 300th question. 100 questions have already been completed for the month of July 2019, and the 200th question from June 2019 is what we're going to have a look at. So all of you guys there in the chat section, in the just in the live session today, need to give me an answer for the last one here. So Prayut Chan-o-Cha has been appointed as a prime minister of which of the following countries? So take your time, and all of you out there need to give me an answer for this. So is it Laos, is it Cambodia, is it Thailand, is it Myanmar or Vietnam, right? So let's try the answer for this particular question. Okay, so most of you going with Thailand. So great. Yes, all of you are going to give me the answer for this particular last question, and then we're going to wind up today. I can see here some question here. How much marks approximately fetched done seriously in 80 marks GA, please reply. Keshav, see, the thing is, this series is for revision. So you should have already done something, and obviously it is going to help you to achieve marks. So I would sincerely advise you to keep revising these questions. So yes, all of you out there who are there in the chat section need to, you know, give me the answer for this last question for today. Only then I'll be signing off. So you need to tell me the correct answer. Fine, so I'm waiting for all of you to give me an answer. My phone battery is about to die, so before that, please do give me the answers below. Okay, so just the last words here, that tomorrow we'll come up with the month of May, as well as half we'll be covering October as well. So both these things will be taken up. The last lecture, that is on 5th of November, we'll have the other half of October, plus some questions from maybe some important indices and reports and union budget and economic survey. We'll club all of that and we'll do, right? So guys, thank you so much for being there till the end. And yes, the answer is Thailand. I was so excited, I did not tell you the answer. Okay, so yes, so As I was telling, I'm really sorry that these are the two courses that we have for Phase 1 RBI Grade B 2019 that EduTap is offering. So you have Phase 1 full video course, which includes the videos for QRE. Then you have mock test, static GK and GA. And the other course that we have is only the test series. Okay. So currently we are running a 50% off, and you can use the coupon code PRELIMS50 to avail the particular discount. Okay. And yes, tomorrow, as I told you, May and the half of October month will be covered, and the PDF of this particular lecture will be provided. You can take it from, download it from EduTap's Telegram channel. And thank you so much, guys, for being there till the end. You all were a great sport. Okay. And thank you for being there till the end. Right. And yes, we'll come out with a quick strategy as well. That also can be done maybe tomorrow. Right. Okay. So any queries, as usual, drop us an email at hello@edutap.co.in. Give us a call on 814-620-7241. You can also visit our website to know the course features, www.edutap.co.in. Thank you so much, and good day, good night, sleep tight, and study well. Thank you.